Hi, I'm Carter. I'm 13 years old, and I've got something to say about Jesus. That's me, the one with the bat. If it's summer, you're gonna find me playing baseball. And I don't mean to brag, but yeah, I'm pretty good. So one day last summer, I was hearing that sound a lot. Bottom of the ninth, last game of the season, and yep, that's me again, over the fence. So I'm taking my victory dance around the bases, when wham! Out of nowhere comes the shortstop. Even though there was nothing he could do to stop my home run, he just decided to plow me over. And his forehead hit me right on the nose. It hurt. Bad. But nothing was gonna stop me from finishing my way around the diamond. I hightailed it to home plate. After my nose got fixed up, our team celebrated with a pizza party. There's only one problem. It's a small town and all of the teams end up at one pizza place. So, guess who else showed up? And guess who I bumped into as I was getting a drink? The shortstop, Aiden Russell. The room got quiet. Every person had seen what had happened on the field. They knew I had every right to be mad at Aiden. I took a deep breath, stood straight up, and said, "Hey, no hard feelings. I usually break it once a year anyway, whether it needs it or not." Everyone was relieved. When Aiden realized I forgave him, he realized he shouldn't have gotten mad about my home run in the first place. And that's where our friendship started. So now, Aiden and I are good friends. I asked him to church a few times, but he didn't seem interested. So, I found another way. One Sunday evening, he wanted to go to the batting cages, but I told him I had a cool Christian concert to go to. And he was welcome to come along, of course. He really liked the music, but he had a lot of questions about the lyrics. All the talk about Jesus and love and forgiveness. Considering the way we met on the baseball field, Aiden could really relate to the way Jesus forgives us. And he really seemed to like the idea that Jesus could forgive anything. I think that's what he needed to hear most of all. And that's where the story ends, right? Just one person told about Jesus and that's it? Wrong! It's just getting started. Aiden's dad was in the Air Force, and they moved around a lot. So he was off to Alamogordo. Sure, I miss him, but we keep in touch by email. He's got new friends, of course, even girls. He was even able to tell a girl named Jessica about Jesus. But her dad was in the Air Force too, and soon, Jessica moved with her parents to Australia. And Jessica must have been really excited, because she told the older woman sitting next to her on the plane. And when she read the Bible at her new school, Rodney asked her what she was doing. And boy, did she ever tell him. And from what I hear, Rodney has lots of friends. So check it out. I told Aiden, who told Jessica, who told the woman on the plane, and Rodney. And it's not just a straight line. Those are just the people I get emails from. Who knows who the woman on the plane told? And Rodney has a huge birthday party next week. I'm Carter. I'm 13 years old. And I've got something to say about Jesus. Thank you.